Okay, so here's the thing. I love surround sound, and every time when I go to a movie theater, it's quite an immersive experience, and I'm sure a lot of you guys can agree with me on that. And personally, I haven't really set one up for myself in the household because I'm currently rocking a 2.1 desktop speaker system from Klipsch, complementing my living room or my TV. And it's been great. The speakers are legendary and I absolutely love it. I don't think I'm getting rid of those anytime soon. In fact, I did a video on those, so if you're interested in checking that out, link right over here. Now, if I really wanted to experience surround sound, I guess the only option I had was to throw on a pair of gaming headsets featuring a virtual 7.1 feature and then, you know, experience it that way. Now, I really wasn't looking for a surround system until Logitech actually sent us a press release on an affordable 5.1 surround system, and I was really intrigued to try it out. So this is the Z606 surround system from Logitech, and it goes for around $130. Now, Logitech's really well known for their speaker systems, but for this particular one, I encountered a few odd decisions, design decisions in particular, that really got my head scratching up for a bit. So let's talk about that right after a message from our sponsor. The new Razer Blade Stealth defines portability without compromising on performance. Featuring Intel's latest 8th-gen CPU and NVIDIA MX150 GPU, up to 16 GB of memory and up to 13 hours of battery life, experience some of the most popular games wherever you are. Learn more about the Blade Stealth down below. All right, so before I get into the setup process and sound quality, I just want to quickly mention that the Z606 is not meant to replace the Z506, but rather it's meant to complement that system because the only additional improvements you're getting is the implementation of Bluetooth 4.2, slightly refined drivers, and of course, a redesign that I will talk about in just a moment. The build quality of the speakers are okay for the price. I'm glad that they didn't go for the glossy finish, but I do love the discreet look. There are also wall mounting options for each of these satellite units, so that's convenient. Now, the rear channel speakers do come with a 20-foot cable, and I think that might pose a problem when it comes to setting this up in a room that's larger than a 12 by 12 foot space, because it's only 20 feet and you might have to use extension cables, which brings me to my next point, and that is the speaker wires are the traditional ones. They're not proprietary, which is nice, but they're hardwired to the speakers themselves. So that's something to keep note of. Now, here's something that's really odd about the design of the Z606. So the center channel speaker, it looks exactly the same as the rest of the satellite units. And that poses a problem when you're trying to place this directly in front of a TV or a monitor, because it actually blocks a little bit of that screen real estate of that display. So that really sucks. I mean, I'm not sure how and why Logitech decided to design something like this, because interestingly enough, if you look at their Z506 setup or their speaker system, the center channel is designed the right way. I mean, it's horizontal, it's nice and flush, so you can comfortably place it in front of a TV or a monitor without blocking any of the screen. So I just feel like this seems to be a more of an afterthought process, but yeah, that's definitely something to keep note of. The subwoofer acts as the central hub for your main controls like volume adjust, switching sources, also switching between 5.1 and 2.1 modes, and other media playback buttons. I will mention that the digital display looks totally different from what Logitech actually advertises on their website, as it's just a standard 7-segment LED that looks ugly and it remains lit when the system's on. Logitech also includes a remote controller with the Z606, and it basically replicates the exact same functionality as what you'll find with the subwoofer. So you can change things like your volume, you have your media playback buttons, as well as switching sources and switching between 5.1 and 2.1 modes as well. You can also change the levels between all these different channels that you have within the setup. And now let's move on to the I/O. And the first thing that I noticed was that every input connection is via analog RCA. So there are no digital inputs like optical. If you want to connect a console or a media streaming box, you'll have to have a receiver and then connect the speakers to the receiver. The layout does offer you two sources plus Bluetooth. According to Logitech, the move to RCA was done in order to increase durability of the connections, but regardless, you still need to use a 3.5mm output on the signal source. Now, out of the box, Logitech does include a 3.5mm to RCA cable, but here's the interesting part. They forgot to include the extra RCA cables that you'd require to set this up in true surround sound. And that's a big disappointment because I had to go dig into my old closet to find those cables to set this up in surround sound, at least true surround sound, that is. Because if you use the standard stereo source, what's going to happen is the processor built inside the subwoofer is going to process that stereo signal to a processed surround sound with the system. And that just wouldn't cut it because it's really meant to offer you truer surround sound. Now, this is a step back, at least in my opinion, because if you look at the Z506, it actually comes with the cables that you need to set it up in true surround sound. And I'm not exactly sure why Logitech just skipped out on a most important key aspect. It is an extra investment. You'll have to spend probably $6 or $10 on these cables, but it just would have been a lot better if the cables were included with a system like this. With that out of the way, I was finally able to set the surround system through my PC, and I started watching Planet Earth on Netflix, which is an amazing show, by the way. And I also did a little bit of gaming as well. And I have to be honest, it was an amazing experience. I mean, those two rear channel speakers definitely adds a layer of immersion when you're consuming media, especially as I was watching Planet Earth, transitioning between different landscapes, I was able to pick up the different sound effects like rainfalls and waterfalls and the beautiful wildlife. It really does complement the visual experience when you're consuming a media. And the same story goes for gaming as well. It just, you know, you can start to hear different positional cues as you're navigating through the gameplay. Now, my only concern with this surround system is the lack of proper bass. Unfortunately, the subwoofer is really not that great. It's pretty muddy, not well tight. It's not very tight. I mean, the sound is not, it just doesn't complement the actual speakers really well. So that's something to keep note of. And I tried increasing the gain level on the subwoofer using the remote, but it still didn't make any difference. So if you're someone who's looking for that extra punch for a subwoofer, especially in a surround sound system, this is definitely not for you. And I just want to quickly go over what processed surround sound looks like, especially in Bluetooth mode as well. It's just really not worth it. I mean, you're actually much better off setting this thing up in true surround sound because your rear channel speakers basically act as a secondary left and right channel speaker. It's basically split, and it's honestly not an amazing experience. So that's something to keep note of. So to conclude, the Z606 surround system from Logitech is definitely a missed opportunity because, you know, basic flaws like the center channel speaker being designed this way just doesn't complete the set, in my opinion. And of course, you don't have the proper cables to get this thing up and running in true surround sound. I mean, sure, the addition of native Bluetooth support is nice, but I mean, really, if they don't include the cables to properly process true surround sound, it completely defeats the purpose of experiencing in the first place. And for $130, it's really hard to recommend. And I think for most users who really don't want to go through the process of routing the cables and wall mounting these satellite speakers, are much better off going for a decent 2.1 system. Not to mention cable management with the system is a nightmare. I mean, just judging by the shot right here, it's a mess, I know. So that's something to consider. But I really want to hear your feedback. I mean, what are you looking for in a speaker system, especially for a certain price? I mean, do you have a certain budget that you're willing to spend on a sound system, whether that's stereo or surround sound? I'd love to know your thoughts in the comments down below. I'm Ibor with Hardware Canucks. Thank you so much for watching. Make sure to check out some relevant content over here. Subscribe to our Boot Sequence channel, and I'll see you in the next one.